Dear 7th standard students, welcome back to this video session of Maths Term 2. Now we are going to solve exercise 1.4. Let us get into the session.
Look at this exercise 1.4. Here we discuss about the how to represent numbers on the number line. Listen, this number line I explained in previous classes, previous standard, right? In geometry, that is scale, how to measure the numbers using scale, that is ruler. The same procedure we have to follow here. In that scale, centimeters and millimeters here, the decimal numbers, whole numbers are here and decimal part number is here. Listen, 0, how will you read out? 0, that is whole number, and then the millimeters 0.1, this one is 0.1, first small line is, and then 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, this long line is 0.5, and then 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, 0.9, and then 1. After that 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, 1.4, 1.5. This long line is 1.5, 1.6, 1.7, 1.8, 1.9, and then 2. After 2, 2.1, 2.3. And then after 3, 3.1, 3.2. After 4 means 4.1, 4.2, 4.3. In between 4 and 5, that is long line is there, that is 4.5. So this procedure we have to follow to represent the points. First question, write the decimal numbers represented by the points P, Q, R, S on the given number line. Listen, they given the number line and they given the points also. How? P, Q, R, S. P denotes which point? That is the answer. How will you find out? Listen, P is denote this line, this small line. 3, 3.1, 3.2, 3.3, 3.4, 3.5, 3.6. So the number lies in between 3 and 4 means this is the whole number, and then how many numbers are there, that is the decimal part. So first P equal to 3.6, right? Next Q. Q is lies between 1 and 2. So 1.123. So it denotes third decimal part. So 1.3. Next one R. What number denotes the R? That is in between 6 and 7. So 6.12. 6.3, 6.4, 6.5, 6.6, 6.7, 6.8, that is R, 6.8. Next, S. S denotes, it is lies between 4 and 5, so 4.1, 4.2. So this number lies between 3 and 4, this number lies between 1 and 2, it is 6 and 7, it lies between 4 and 5. So that is the answer. Second sum, represents the following decimal numbers on the number line. They given the decimal numbers and we have to point out on the number line. First one, 1.7. 1.7 means it lies between 1 and 2. First whole number and at next whole number is 2. So in between 1.7 is there. 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, 1.4, 1.5, 1.6, 1.7. So this is the 1.7 here. Right? Next one, 0.3. 0.3 means the whole number is 0 and next number is 1. So in between 0.3 is there. 0.1, 0.2, 0.3. So here 0.3. Next one, 2.1. Here roll number is 2. So next number 3. So in between 2.1 is there. So 2 and 3, 2.1 is here. 2.1. So that is the answer. Third sum, between which two whole numbers the following decimal numbers lie? Listen, they given the decimal numbers. In between two whole numbers, the number will lies on the number line. So we have to find out the two numbers. Listen, 3.3. The whole number is 3. First number, 3.3. Listen, first whole number is 3. Next whole number is 4. So in between, the 3.3 is lies on the number line. Listen, 3.3, 3.1, 3.2, 3.3. It lies in between 3 and 4. So answer lies between the whole number 3 and 4. That is the answer. Next one, 2.5. Same procedure, first whole number is 2. So 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4, 2.5. So 2.5 is there. In between two whole numbers, that is 2 and 3. So 2.5 lies between the whole numbers 2 and 3. That is the answer. Next one, 0.9. 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, 0.9. So the number lies here. Which two number in between, that is 0 and 1, is the two whole numbers. 0.9 is lies between the whole number 0 and 1. That is the answer. Fourth sum, find the greater decimal number in the following. Listen, 2.3, 3.2. Compare the whole number part here, 2, 3. So which one is greater? 3 point. So 3.2 is greater than 2.3. So we have to write the greater number. Greater number is 3.2. Next one, 5.6, 6.5. Same procedure, compare the whole number part first. Here 5, here 6. So 6.5 is greater than 5.6. Therefore, greater number is 6.5. Next one, 1.2, 2.1. Whole number part is 1, here 2. So that is greater than 1.2. Therefore, greater number is 2.1. That is the answer. Fifth sum, find the smaller decimal numbers in the following. Listen, 25.3, 25.03. Listen, the whole number part, 25 equal. So 10th place here 3, here 0. 3, 0. So which one is smaller? 25.03 is smaller. So 25.3 is greater than 25.03. Therefore, smaller number is 25.03. That is the answer. Next one, 7.01 and 7.3. Here also, whole number part is equal, 7, 7. And then we have to compare the 10th place, 0, 3. Here 0, here 3. Which one is smaller? 0 is smaller. So 7.01 is smaller than 7.3. Therefore, smaller number is 7.01. Next, 5.6. And 6.05. Compare the whole number part, here 5, here 6. So 5 is the smaller one. So 5.6 is smaller than 6.05. Therefore, smaller number is 5.6. That is the answer. Here exercise 1.4 is over. So children, practice well. I'll see you again in next exercise. Thank you.